Right now on BBC One, Chris Tarrant attempts to seriously unbalance the status quo.
Weekly rave party. Welcome to Pop Quiz. It's basically a quiz about pop. As usual, there are no prizes to be won, largely because the producer forgot to go to the car boot sale this afternoon. So once again, our two teams are playing simply for the glory of displaying their immense musical knowledge, ranging from the 60s well into the 90s, as indeed are both of our team captains. Leader of the first team is a man who once uttered the immortal words, "Good evening, Stockholm," to a bewildered audience in Amsterdam, Mr. Rick Parfitt. Playing alongside Rick is a performer with a string of top 20 hits to her credit, Kim Appleby. And out there on the end, soul singer who loves to exhibit his chinchillas, apparently, Kenny Thomas. Now, you're probably thinking, what sort of a man can captain a team facing Rick Parfitt and still have an outside chance of losing? Well, this sort of man. The brains behind status quo, Francis Rossi. Sitting next to Rossi, someone has to, the fine member of the band Capella, Kelly Overett. Way over there, singer and songwriter, star of Big Country, Stuart Adamson. Now, before our two teams lock horns, it's worth pointing out to our younger viewers, which is basically anyone under the age of about 68, that status quo, as led by team captains Rossi and Parfitt, were once considered to be the take that of their time. And here to prove it, our Parfitt and Rossi looking worryingly pretty. That clip's nothing whatsoever to do with the show. It just brings me enormous pleasure to play it. Right, back at Pop Quiz, we start with a round of cameo appearances. I'm going to show each team clips from three different videos. Each video has a cameo appearance by a hugely famous celebrity, actor or comedian tucked away somewhere inside the whole thing. Now, for one point, you've got to give me the name of the artist, and for a further point, give me the name of their special guest on each one. Right, Parfitt and your team, what? Here's your musical montage.
Don't worry, don't do it. Be happy. Put a smile on your face. Don't bring everybody down like this. Don't worry.
No, I don't. Listen to their wasted lines. Got my eyes wide open. I don't see the signs. Cause they don't know about us. They've never heard of love.
Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na.
Come on, Rick and Co. Okay. I need to know, first and foremost, the artist in the first clip.
Well, we think we've done quite well here. Confirmed.
Do you want to
do that one? Well, no, we know that the guest is Robin Williams. one of the guests.
Okay. That's all he needs to know.
Yeah. No, but you need to know the artist as well.
Bobby McFerrin.
Yes.
That's right.
Excellent.
Okay, you got 2 points. Give me the next one.
Paul McCartney was the guest,
yeah,
alongside Tracy Ullman.
Last one.
Next one was Chevy Chase.
Chevy Chase was the guest.
Paul Simon.
Yeah. Paul Simon, you could call me Al. You got the lot. 6 points. Terribly well done. Right, Rossi, your team. Try and pick the bones out of this lot. Now, once again, we want to know who's singing and who's the surprise guest in each clip. Rossi and team, probably more team than Rossi, I suspect.
What was the first one?
The first one we think was the Bangles with the.
Leonard
Nimoy.
You get 2 points in amongst all that. Okay, well done.
The second one, the guest was Frankie Howard.
Frankie Howard?
The farm, right?
Yeah, you're doing well.
Frankie Howard on the farm.
And Rick Meal in the last one.
Rick Meal was the guest.
Art of Noise
featuring
Peter Gunn with Dwayne Eddy.
With Dwayne Eddy's, right, you got a lot. 6 points. Terribly well done. Right, let's have a look at the scores. At the end of the first round, 6 points to Francis Ross's team, 6 points to Rick Parfitt's team. Right, here we go. Now, for some reason best known to our skinhead lager lout producer, strange woman, comes an individual round called Football Songs. And if you think that sounds quite appalling prospect, you're probably right. Each team member will be forced to listen to a bit of a song performed by a well-known footballer. For 2 points, I'll want the name of the singing soccer star. Kelly, you kick off. Bit of a joke. Brace yourselves for this.
Well, why do you wanna make those eyes?
Those eyes
of
people.
If
you
don't mean what they say.
What do you wanna make those eyes at me for? Terry Venables.
He's right for 2 points. Kim, 2 points for this. Have a little listen at the end. Tell me who on earth it was.
When I'm strolling, strolling, help me out, Les. By the light of the moon above.
You're on your own.
Whoever released that certainly shouldn't have done it.
Who?
Oh, Nora D. Thought we heard.
Who was it?
Any idea, Francis?
Certainly not picking up any bonus points, are we?
If you please, we ran it. Oh, it's Jimmy... It wasn't Glenn Hoddle, it's Jimmy Green.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody else you can't do. Right, Francis, pin back your ears, have a little listen to this musical feast.
We used to sit on Granddad's knee. And how we used to love the jam and butter we had for tea.
What a team!
Rossi.
It's Jack Charlton.
It is Jack Charlton.
And Geordie Sunday. I think you'll find is the answer, Chris.
Geordie
Sunday.
Jack Charlton, well done. And it's only good luck to Jack and the Republic of Ireland, who are playing their first match of the World Cup in about 2 hours' time. Right, Rick, 2 points for the artist. Have a listen. Parfitt.
I think it was Glenn Hoddle and his rhyming mate, Waddle. Hoddle and Waddle.
Hoddle and Waddle.
Yeah.
It's actually right for 2 points.
Oh,
Got to number 12 in the charts in 1987. God, what a year that must have been. Here we are then, Stuart. Your player sings something like this.
And it looks like I'm falling.
The engineer on this one. Go on.
Kevin Keegan.
Kevin Keegan's right. It's called Head Over Heels in Love. Well done, you got two more points. Sickeningly high standard. Right, Kenny, last one. 2 points for the artist. Who on earth is it?
Go, go, go. Don't come around and get on down. You know you're gonna score. Spread the word all over town.
Weeping Gazza.
Weeping Gazza, Paul Gascoigne with, yeah. Do you know the name of the group you sang with?
Oh,
the Gazettes.
Yes. The Gazettes. Fog on the Tyne.
Fog on the Tyne. Oh. It's Lindisfarne. I'll give you 2 points anyway. Well done. Well, let's have a look at the scores at the end of that round. 10 points now to Mr. Parfitt's team, 12 to Mr. Rossi and co. Right, this is the round which makes even the hardest living rock stars squirm with embarrassment and agony. It's the lyric round. Oh, good. I'll give each of the players some lyrics. For 1 point, they've got to tell me the name of the song, and for another point, the name of the artist. Kim, we start with you.
I've wasted all my tears, wasted all those years.
Mick Hucknall, Simply Red.
The song's called?
Holding Back the Years.
It's right for 2 points, right?
Yes.
Right, Kelly, your turn. 1 point for the artist, 1 point for the song. I love you, though you hurt me. So now I'm going to pack my things and go. I love you, though you hurt me. Now
I'm going to pack my things and go. Tainted love. Yeah.
Get it right.
Soft Cell, Tainted Love.
It's right for 2 points. Your thing will probably fall apart. Parfitt.
What?
Here's your lyrics. When you were young.
Yeah, go on.
And on your own.
Yeah, go on.
How did it feel to be alone? Oh. When you were young and on your own.
Do we get an extra point if I sing it? Or do we? Do you
deduct probably will give you an extra point if you sing it.
Cause only love can break your heart. What about that? That's it, isn't
it? Are you going to sing it?
I'll just sing
it. Sorry.
What do you think? Neil Young, only love can break your heart.
Neil Young, only love can break your heart. And we'll give you an extra point for singing. Francis Rossi, your turn. Remember, 1 point for the song, 1 point for the artist. Look at him.
Brilliant.
Working, darning his socks.
Oh.
In the night, when there's nobody
look
there.
Look at him working, darling. There's something in there. Eleanor Rigby.
You better sing it.
I did a quick one.
Can you dance as well?
It's right, you've got 2 points.
I think. Extra point for that vocal.
I just did it quicker than you, it's all.
It was Will Moody.
No extra points for that, right?
As well. No, quick. Come on, it's indistinct, yeah.
We won't.
Yeah, we're not going to have this. We're not going to have any extra points for that.
I don't want any trouble.
That was a top wiggle. Oh, that's what they're for.
Kenny Thomas, 1 point for the artist, 1 point for the song. Here are your lyrics in amongst all this. Now we're up to talking divorce, and we weren't even married.
Not my question.
Artist and a soul.
Yeah. Michael McDonald, Patti LaBelle, On My Own.
It's right for 2 points. Well done. Right, 17 to Rick, 16 to Francis. Stuart, you to play there for 2 points. Here's your lyrics. If I only could, I'd make a deal with God. And I'd get him to swap our places.
I'll bet you would, Chris.
What at this moment?
Keep only... running up that hill.
You've got to sing it.
If I only could, I'd make a deal with God and get him to swap our places. You run up that hill.
Absolutely right. All right, you got a bonus point. Right, let's have a look at the scores at the end of that round. Stuart's clinched that one, actually. Rick Parfitt now 17, Francis Rossi and co, 19. Right, here we go, another round based on clips plundered from the BBC's vast and ancient video vaults. That's just underneath Marmaduke Hussey's private bathroom. You get it right, you get 2 points. Kim, you're first. Take a look at this. Okay, Kim, right, I can tell you it's Lenny Kravitz, so that's not what I want to know. I want to know the name. I want to know the name of Lenny Kravitz's debut album for 1 point.
Oh, you're joking. Are you going to go my way?
No.
Was it?
I can offer it.
Quiet Love Rule.
It's right for a point. What else? Let Love Rule. Right, Kim, you can still get another point. Lenny Kravitz wrote and produced Be My Baby for which French starlet?
Vanessa Paradis.
It's right for a point. Well done.
Yes.
Right, Kelly, this is your clip. Rare footage of this woman with all of her clothes on. Right, 2 points then, Kelly. Can you tell me four of Madonna's seven UK number one hits?
Yeah. Like a Prayer.
It's one.
Number one. It's the number one, yeah?
Oh. That's the number one.
Vogue.
Vogue's right.
Papa Don't Preach.
Papa Don't, you need one more, you've got 2 points.
Into the Groove.
Into the Groove's right, you got the lot. Well done, 2 points. Whoa, you could have had Lucky Benita, who's that girl, in True Blue as well, but you didn't need them. Well done, Kelly. Right, Mr. Parfitt, have a little look at this.
As the bar and date, the cafe down the street tomorrow evening. His head was reeling when she said yes. Okay. Don't be afraid. Just knock on the door. Well, he just stood there mumbling and fumbling. Then a voice from above said, come this way, this is your life. Go out and fight yourself away.
Right, Rick, I need to know these. Point for this. That was Jeff Lynne and ELO for 1 point. So I don't need any of that.
Yeah.
But with which band did Jeff Lynne have his first ever hit?
The Move.
It's right. Can you name the hit?
Conquest.
Doesn't matter. I can tell you it was Brontosaurus. What a belter that was. Number seven, April 1970 for The Move. Right, for another point, Parfitt. Come on, you're on a flyer here. Yeah. Further point, what was ELO's only UK number one hit?
Telephone Man.
Like, no.
No. Well, I don't know then.
The answer, very close, is Xanadu. With the Olivia Newton-John. Francis, here's yours. 2 points for a correct answer arising from this clip. Now, it's a band who just rented their costumes from Mossbos.
I'm gonna kiss you from your head to your toes. Then I'm gonna travel deep inside your soul. I'm gonna play games with your mind. Open your heart and see what we might find. A little love, some love to give back to me. Whisper to my spirit and tell me exactly how much you love me, how much you care. How much I can touch, how much and where. Yeah, as our games come to an end. We start again. Yeah, to the chorus.
Oh, good. There's an extra point for singing, Francis. Right. For 1 point, what was E17's first ever UK hit?
House of Love.
House of Love is right. He's more surprised than you. Which single are E17 currently in the UK charts with?
Yes, I know that. I'm Been Around the World.
Been Around the World. How does that go, Francis?
There's no place like home. Oh, baby.
Go for it, Kelly.
Come on.
All right, we'll give you an extra point. What are you saying? A little bit. Good enough. Right, Kenny, here we go with yours. Have a look at the clip first. But now it's Kate. Girl, you seem to change every day. Alexander O'Neill, God, if he sweats like that on stage, whatever is he like in a sauna bath? Right, here we are. Kenny, your question. Name one of the two hits that Alexander O'Neill had with Sherelle.
Saturday Love.
Is right.
Saturday Love, Saturday Love. It goes like that, and I'll sing the rest later.
I'll give you a point just for bravery, really. Okay, give you a couple of points for that. Another question, Kenny, can get another point. Which famous American producers is Big Bad Alexander O'Neill most associated with?
Jimmy Jam, Terry Lewis.
He's right, good grief. Right, Stuart, last one of this round before we go to the buzz round. Here's your clip. Now, it features a lead singer who looks rather like a bank manager.
Yesterday. Well, it seemed so cool when I walked you home, kissed goodnight. I said it's love, you said all right. It's funny how I could never cry until tonight, and you passed by and had with another guy.
Right, Stuart, for a point, can you name the five key members of the original Roxy Music lineup?
Paul Thompson, Phil Manzanera,
yep.
Brian Eno,
yep.
Brian Ferry,
yep.
Obviously.
Excuse me?
Nothing.
Wait a minute, Phil Manzanera, Paul Thompson, Andy Mackay.
Andy Mackay's right, for a point, well done. Right, for another point. What was Roxy Music's only UK number one single?
Love is a Drug.
It wasn't. I can offer it to you.
Dance Away to Heartache, Chris?
It's not. It's Jealous Guy. It was the only number one that Roxy Music have had. Right, let's have a look at the scores. We got to the final round. It's very close. Rick Parfitt, Kim and Kenny now on 22. But Kelly, Francis, Rossi and Stuart on 26. Right, here we go. Another all-action nail-biter of a last round. It's the buzzer round. 2 points for a correct answer. To stop any gamesmanship or cheating, as there has been in recent weeks, like last week and the week before and the week before, if you get it wrong, we will offer it to the other team for a bonus point. OK, so no bluffing on your buzzers. Fingers on your buzzers. Well, they're not actually buzzers this week. By way of a tribute...
comes a novel.
Instead of the familiar buzzing noise, bzz, that we normally use, they're classic... quo chords.
Shall we go?
Oh, I like that.
Right, well, many more than three
very, very, very quick round. Yes, I think that's demonstrated the full range. Right, here we go.
Sorry. Whoa.
Jesse? Right. 2 points for the correct answer, one bonus point if the wrong answer is given, or there is a nasty, unpleasant interruption. Right, who is Georgios Panion? It's taking a bit of getting used to this, isn't it? Right, Kelly.
George Michael.
George Michael's right for 2 points. Who is the groover from Vancouver?
Yes.
Kelly.
Brian Adams.
He's right, groover from Vancouver.
You what?
Who went surfing USA?
The Beach Boys.
What did the spin doctors take from Superman?
Pocket
Stuart.
Full of kryptonite.
Pocket full of kryptonite's right for two more points. Oh, you're back now. Who had songs in the key of life?
Stevie Stuart. Wonder.
Stevie Wonder's right for two more points. 36 plays 22, right. Who ate his American pie? Good grief! It's Rick Parfitt's team.
Don McLean.
He's right, one up for 2 points. 24 plays 36, and I tell you what, you could still catch up. You probably won't, but you could. Right, who has the patience of angels? Stuart.
Eddie Reader.
Is right, big hit at the moment in the charts. Who reckons size isn't everything? I can't accept,
look,
I can't accept I men as an answer, and you didn't press your buzzer. Rick.
Is it the Bee Gees?
It's the Bee Gees, he's right for 2 points. Wow! Especially for you was a 19...
Kylie Minogue and Jason Donovan.
Kylie and Jason is right. In 1988, which Rolling Stone performed on Carly Simon's You're So Vain? Rick!
Oh, God, I've got a guess.
No, don't.
Mick Jagger.
Mick Jagger's right. I'll give you 2 points. Oh. Right, what was Carl Douglas's 1974? Kim!
Kung Fu Fighter.
Is right for 2 more points. You can still catch. Who is the lead singer of Simple Minds? Stuart.
Jim Kerr.
Jim Kerr is right. Sunshine on a Rainy Day was a 19... Kelly.
Zoe.
For Zoe is right. Who's the lead singer with Sham 69? Stuart.
Jimmy Percy.
Is right for 2 more points. Name the rapper who owns an office cleaning and telephone sanitizing company. Kenny.
Vanilla Rice has got to be doing something now, hasn't he?
I'll give you a point anyway, just for being silly, really, and being so far behind. Right, 15 between you, 2 questions left, 2 points apiece. Who was the lead singer with the Cars? Stuart.
Rick O'Keefe.
Is right, correct. Last one, 31 plays 48. Big one to win this one, Rick. Who had hits with Buffalo Stance and Manchild? Kim.
Nana Cherry.
Is right, Nana Cherry, right. Right, let's have a look at those scores. Final scores, 33 to Rick Parfitt's team. A huge, frightening 48 points to Francis Rossi, Kelly and Stuart. Oh, dear, that's just about it for us. Thanks to Kelly Everett, to Francis Rossi. What a lovely, good sportsmanlike game this is. And Stuart Adamson, the winners. And to Kenny Thomas, Rick Parfitt and Kim Appleby, the losers by a huge margin. For all of you headbanger status quo fans, you've been on the phone for the last 28 minutes saying, when we showed that clip earlier, who exactly are this Take That lot? We leave you with Take That. And the song, just testing, and the song which recently won Gary Barlow. And Ivor Novello. Award. We'll see you next week on Pop Quiz. Bye bye. Longer I stayed away for, hiding from a word I need to hear now. Don't think I'll hear it again. Stay tuned for a wild celebrity goose chase where the goose is a penguin. BBC One hits the road next. All I do each night is pray. When Wimbledon's on, Ramsey Street moves. And when Ramsey Street moves,